Welcome. My name's Adrian, and I'm a radiation therapist at the Bendigo Radiotherapy Center, operated by Peter Mack. In this video, I'll be providing you with some information on what radiotherapy is, how it works, and what to expect for your appointments with us. If you'll come with me, I'll take you for a brief tour around the department.
Throughout your radiation therapy journey, you may meet many different types of healthcare professionals who will work together as a team to deliver your care. These include your radiation oncologists, radiation therapists, radiation therapy nurses, medical physicists, and clerical staff. Prior to beginning your radiation therapy treatment, you will have a consultation with your radiation oncologist. Your radiation oncologist will review your full medical history, including pathology results and scans, and may also perform a physical examination. After consulting with other health professionals, they will then provide you with and explain your treatment options at a scheduled appointment time. We encourage you to take this opportunity to ask questions and clarify any aspects of the treatment that may be unclear to you. Radiation therapy is one option in the treatment of cancer. It can be used alone or alongside chemotherapy and surgery. Radiation therapy is the use of powerful X-ray radiation to kill cancer cells by damaging their DNA. As a result, the cancer cells are unable to divide and grow, and so the cancer cells die. Radiation can also damage healthy cells. However, healthy cells are able to repair themselves more than cancer cells. Unlike chemotherapy, which can affect the entire body, radiation therapy will only affect the parts of your body directly surrounding the treatment area. Before your first treatment appointment, you may be scheduled to have a planning CT scan. This CT appointment is not intended to provide additional information about your diagnosis. The scan will provide us with valuable information to create your individual treatment plan. You will be scanned in a reasonably comfortable and stable position, with your arms above your head. It is important that you're in a comfortable position during your CT scan, as this will help you to maintain the same position every day for your treatment. The radiation therapists may use a range of equipment to keep you in position and will use lasers in the room to ensure you are lined up straight on the bed. Once the radiation therapists are happy with your position, they will perform your CT scan and take some measurements. You may receive very small permanent tattoo marks, smaller than a freckle, to help reproduce your position every day on treatment. Now that you've had your planning CT scan, your radiation oncologist and a radiation therapist will review a scan to create a plan specific to your anatomy and treatment area. Your radiation oncologist will identify and outline on the CT scan the areas that need to be treated, known as a target volume, and also the areas that need to be avoided, such as surrounding organs and healthy tissue. The radiation therapist will then plan your treatment on a computer planning system, which allows them to focus those to the target, using radiation beams from multiple angles and limit any dose to the surrounding healthy organs. Your radiation therapist will develop a specific plan for your anatomy and treatment area to achieve the best plan for you and to reduce side effects as much as possible. In this image, we are treating an esophagus. You can see the target volume for treatment is colored in red. This means that it is receiving a high dose of radiation, and the dose to the surrounding organs can be seen in blue. This means that the normal tissues are receiving very little to no dose of radiation. These treatment angles were selected for this plan to minimize the dose to normal tissue and focus the dose on the target volume. Once your plan has been approved by your radiation oncologist, the final plan is reviewed and checked by the radiation therapy and medical physics team before it is used for your treatment. The time between the planning CT scan appointment and your first treatment appointment can vary depending on how complex your treatment plan is. On your first day of treatment, a radiation therapist will explain the treatment process to you and your family. Your first treatment appointment will be your longest. Extra measurements will be taken to ensure that everything has been prepared accurately from the planning phase. In most cases, after the first day, you can expect your treatment appointment to take between 15 to 20 minutes. The radiation itself will typically only be on for 1 to 5 minutes in total. The rest of your appointment time will be spent in the room with the radiation therapists, setting you up appropriately and ensuring that we are treating the target accurately every day. This machine is called a linear accelerator. It will deliver your treatment using electricity to create strong and powerful X-ray radiation to the target area your radiation oncologist wishes to treat. The machine will move around you to best deliver the treatment from different angles, and it may come close, but it won't touch you. The treatment is painless, and you will not see or feel anything when the radiation is on, but you may hear a noise from the machine. Radiation is only produced when the machine is turned on. This means that once the machine is turned off, there is no radiation present either within yourself or in the room. At a treatment session, you will be shown into the treatment room and you will lie down in the same position you were in for your planning CT scan. There will always be two radiation therapists performing your treatment. They will use the in-room lasers, measurements, and the tattoo marks placed on your skin to assess your position on a daily basis. The radiation therapists will move you as you lay on the bed to get you in the exact same position. Once your radiation therapists are happy with your position, they will leave the room to deliver the treatment from outside. Your radiation therapists will be in the control room during your treatment. They have cameras and microphones available so they can see you and hear you at all times. The radiation therapists can also talk to you if needed. If you need anything whilst the treatment is underway, please stay still and call out. Before your treatment is delivered, it will be necessary to take an X-ray image of your position every day. The machine has large arms that extend from the sides to take an X-ray image. The images taken of you at treatment will be compared with an image taken from your CT scan to correct for small changes in your position. This ensures we are delivering your treatment to the intended area as accurately as possible. Once these images have been taken, you may feel the treatment bed move underneath you to fine-tune your position based on the images taken. Even though the treatment staff are outside the room, they are still in control of the machine during your treatment. Once your position has been fine-tuned, the treatment will begin. During your treatment, several parts of the machine can move around you. The main part of the machine that will move around you is called the gantry. The gantry can either deliver treatment whilst it is moving or stop and deliver treatment from different angles. For this person, the treatment is being delivered when the machine is stationary. The machine will move to the appropriate angles and stop to deliver the treatment. The X-rays are delivered from this part of the linear accelerator and uses metal shielding to precisely shape the X-rays specifically for your treatment. In the bottom left-hand corner, you can see the different shapes being created by the shielding. In this example, the target is red, and the other organs are displayed by other colors. As you can see, the shielding surrounds the target area and protects as much of the healthy organs as possible. If you would like to know more about which technique is being used for your treatment, please ask a radiation therapist. On the first and last day of treatment, you will have an appointment with our nursing team to go through the best way to look after yourself during and after treatment. They will also speak to you about the importance of maintaining a normal diet and adequate fluid intake. They will also refer you to the dietitian as needed. The nurses will continue to meet with you during the course of your treatment to see how you're going and to help you manage any side effects. Your radiation oncologist may meet with you during the course of your treatment. This is an opportunity to make sure any side effects are being managed properly and you are still fit and healthy during your treatment. It also gives you and your family an opportunity to ask any questions that you may have. If you have any concerns between appointments, it is very important that you let a nurse or the radiation therapists know, and an additional appointment can be made with either a nurse or a radiation oncologist. To minimize side effects, care begins on the first day of treatment and continues for at least 3 weeks after finishing your treatment. Typical side effects from radiation therapy to the upper gastrointestinal area can include fatigue, which is the most common side effect of radiotherapy. nausea, which is an unpleasant wave-like feeling in the back of the throat and or the stomach. Pain or difficulty swallowing. It is important to maintain your diet and adequate fluid intake throughout your treatment. Skin sensitivity. Treatment can cause your skin to be more red, dry, itchy, discolored, sensitive to the sun, and pimply. You may also experience pain or discomfort in the area of treatment. If you are experiencing any of these side effects, please seek advice from your radiation oncologist, dietitian, or nursing staff. At the Bendigo Radiotherapy Center, we also have a team of allied health professionals that can help to support you during your treatment. These include physiotherapists, occupational therapists, social workers, dietitians, and a speech pathologist. Not everyone will require these services, and your radiation oncologist, nurses, or a radiation therapist will refer you to these services as you need them. We also offer cancer council education workshops, fatigue management sessions, and quit smoking consultations for additional support. Before the conclusion of your treatment, your radiation oncologist will discuss whether you require any follow-up appointments. You may have follow-up appointments with some or all of the following: your radiation oncologist, medical oncologist, surgeon, or GP. On the last day of treatment, the nursing team will also discuss options for continuing support for you after your treatment has finished.
A lot more pleasant than what I expected it to be, because basically you're just lying down in the machine still, and you can't feel anything.
I have sort of enjoyed it, if you can sort of say that. All the people here have been very nice to me. Everybody's been exceptional, and I don't think anybody should be sort of fear it or putting their mind in a place that's going to upset them, sort of thing. And I'm going to walk away here in a couple of days and sort of, oh, that's all over, just like that.
Anything new is always a little bit scary if you don't know what you're going into, but you know, the great staff and the people that are around you, you know, are very comforting with questions that need to be answered. If you want to know what's going to be happening, my kids have come in, they've told them what's happening during radiation, all that kind of stuff. So it's actually been quite a nice experience for something that you have to have done as cancer treatment.
Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask your radiation therapist, a nurse, or your radiation oncologist.